And the Lagos State Government, Babajide Sanwo-Olu, has waded into the lingering land dispute in Magodo Phase 2 estate. The governor visited the estate on Tuesday and invited all parties involved for a meeting in his office on Wednesday. Earlier in the day, Magodo residents had staged a protest over the presence of policemen in the estate. Court bailiffs had also sealed some property in the estate in the enforcement of a Supreme Court judgment.
A very difficult one to start the new year like this. And it's because of the importance that we see to all of the misinformation and lack of proper information that I had to take up this assignment myself. When the first attempt, as in coming to the resident association, coming to the estate, happened about a week and a half, 2 weeks ago, before the new year, I indeed intervened. And if you remember very well, you know, the action was immediately, you know, halted, and there were no incidents again. You know, and throughout the festive period, we had started communication.
Well, joining us now is Mr. Gbenga Omotosho, Commissioner for Information, Lagos State. Hello, Mr. Omotosho.
Good evening.
Good evening, and thanks for joining us.
All right.
Well, earlier today, the governor went to Magodo Phase 2. Can you tell us about the ongoing crisis in that estate?
Well, there is a family that that won a judgment over that in which the Supreme Court said they should be given 500 and plots of a land in by the Lagos State government. But the case has been on for so long. I think it's about 20 years now. And then when Mr. Babajide Sanwo-Olu, the governor, came in and he saw the file, he immediately set up a committee to look at the matter. And the committee has been meeting. And unfortunately, perhaps because this judgment creditors did not know that the committee was meeting, they now decided to do what they are doing in Magodo now. I understand they have the backing of the Attorney General of the Federation and the police chief. And the governor, as you heard in that report, came in and asked all the parties to stay action, and that he was going to begin dialogue over the matter. And he went there today when things started to go wrong. And then he was able to calm afraid nerves. He was able to talk to the Attorney General of the Federation. He was able to talk to the police chief and even all the policemen who were there, asking them to stand down. And that is the situation now. Tomorrow, a meeting is going to be convened in Alausa, the government secretariat, of all the parties involved in this crisis, in an attempt to find a peaceful way out of the crisis. And I hope that after that meeting, everybody will see the sincerity of the government is certainly the matter, because like the governor said, all the parties, the police, the claimants, judgment claimants, creditors, and then the tenants in Magodo and the landlords in Magodo, they all belong to us. They are all Lagosians, and the governor is the father of all, and he is ready to settle the matter, and it will be settled.
They're all Lagosians and they all belong to the to Lagos. But this situation seems very obnoxious. First of all, you have the Attorney General of the Federation himself sending a different police commissioner there, which sparked some sort of controversy. And then you have this situation, which is very dire. You have the Shangisha Landlords Association on one side, who are saying their lands were forcefully taken from them, and that they're accusing the Lagos State government of refusing to obey the court orders. And then on the other hand, you have the residents living there who have proper title. This is a very serious, anything that has to do with land is usually very difficult to tackle. How do you see this being resolved? There is a meeting called for tomorrow.
Yeah, it's, if you look at it from the surface, if you look at this superficially, it's a very difficult problem. It's not a problem that cannot be resolved. The governor believes that there is nothing that dialogue cannot resolve. And that is why he's calling all the parties to come to the round table. Even after winning a judgment, there is no way that you want to enforce the judgment by using force. And like you have said, the landlords of Magodo, they have a proper titles to their properties in Magodo. So there is no way the government can just say that they should leave the place for the family that is saying that they have won the case. And the family too, the government cannot say they should just go away and then be holding only the paper in their hands as their judgment. That's why the government is calling all of these sides together. And the government is very clear that they should be giving plots of land. And the government will look at that and see how everybody can be pleased, so that no side will see the government as taking sides, and no side will see that the government is not doing what the law is saying. So the government is going to look at the judgment and then see how these people can be settled. But now the government is asking for peace in Magodo, and is happy that peace has been restored in Magodo. That is the most important thing now. The other part of it is going to be settled on the table.
Settled on the table. So I guess that we'll find out tomorrow after the meeting.
Sure.
So what about those whose houses have been marked to who have been threatened with demolition? What is their fate at the moment?
The state government does not believe that that should happen. And the state government has said that that situation should be reversed. Everybody should go back to the status quo. Since we are calling for dialogue, you cannot be calling for dialogue and at the same time encouraging people to go around marking people's houses. That is not the way to go. As I have said, Mr. Baide Sanwo-Olu, the governor, believes that there is no matter that cannot be settled through dialogue. And that is the system that we are going to employ in this case. And he has said that they should come to allow us that tomorrow. So the marking of houses should stop, and people trying to demolish houses. I was there, the governor was there. I didn't see any bulldozer trying to do that. And you do not commit an illegality by trying to correct what you perceive as an illegality. Like our people say, two wrongs don't make a right. So I do not see why anybody should go in there and begin to demolish houses or marking houses. Once the governor has stepped into the matter and he has pledged publicly that he's going to resolve the matter, I do not see why anybody should continue to make trouble. So for now, there is peace in Magodo. The people's houses have been marked. They should just stay calm. And people who believe that they are being threatened, that their homes could be demolished, they should stay calm. Nobody's house is going to be demolished in Magodo.
Well, thank you so much, Mr. Gbenga Omotosho, Commissioner for Information, Lagos State. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Hello. Hope you enjoyed the news. Please do subscribe to our YouTube channel and don't forget to hit the notification button so you get notified about fresh news updates.